is working with you behind the scenes, and if you do have an agitator like Penina, like Hannah had, God has said that he will prepare a table before you in the presence of your enemies. Amen. All you gotta do is live your life and wait for the feast. Amen. Because there is a feast coming. There is a blessing coming. God has not forgotten you. He is allowing you to have some long suffering in order to bring out the best oil. When you go somewhere, you don't want somebody to hand you the best meal on the garbage can. But he's going to work on the inside. And when what's going on the inside will definitely show up on the outside.
Amen.
And when you hear people speak, I always tell them, I don't judge. I am fruit inspecting. What you saying ain't lining up what you're doing. And so you got to be an example even in that. Sometimes, even right now, there's something going on my job. I'm praying how to approach the executive director about it. We are a faith-based organization. We embrace diversity, but I think they done took it a little too far. They are allowing a member, I mean, a co-worker to celebrate one of her holidays in her tradition, and it is the Day of the Dead. They are allowing her to erect an altar in the office. They are allowing her to bring pictures of her dead living loved ones, and they have these ceremonies. I'm like, that's worship. And there are those of us in the office, it's participation is optional, but it's a difference between respecting someone and then putting it in our face. Because I said, I'll give the example. I ain't walking around with my oil slinging it on everybody. Say, come on, get in this line so I can pray for these demons inside of you. I'm not doing that. But what I'm saying is just pray for us because we just didn't get an opportunity to talk to him before he told her, yeah. And I don't want the young lady to be offended if she see that half of us are not doing this. And it is because we are a faith-based organization. We believe in the Bible. And the Bible tells us that the dead know not what the living doing. And we don't have to do all of those things. We worship God and God alone. And we don't bring offerings to nobody but him. So just pray for my office, y'all. We got a gang of us going to have a talk with him. I don't know if he read it, thought it through. I don't know. But there is godly counsel going on and we're going to bring it to him some kind of way. So just pray for us. But I just want to encourage you to know that God, our thing was, it's working. Guess what? It's still working. For the people that are naysayers of our ministry, we're still here. Because it's working. And God is going to do greater and bigger things. And you know what? Pastor preached a sermon suddenly. That's exactly how everything is going to happen. They're going to say all of a sudden, it was just 12 of them. How did it get to be 600? How did it get to be 500? How did it get to be 800? It seemed like it just happened overnight.
Man.
But no, they don't see the story. What they see is the glory. And God rewards faithfulness. Be faithful. Trust him. Step out on faith. Come on out your comfort zone. Come on out and step out into the deep water. Step out off the shore. We like to watch and speculate just so the water can touch our feet. But we need to be submersed under the water and know that God will take us up and that he is going to carry us on. Pray my strength in the Lord.
Amen.
I'm at home, you all. I'm in the bathroom. There is no way I can live without you. I have tried to make it on my own, on my own. But the burdens in my life, they got a little too strong. Without Christ in my life, there is no way.